Hello and welcome to Design Inc. In this tutorial, I'm going to go through how you can use a brand guide template to help you design your colors and fonts for Squarespace. I prepared a template for you in Canva and you can download it using the link below. Let's take a look. Let's head into our Canva template. If you've signed up for the template, you'll be given a link and you just copy the link and you'll be led to this template. We'll hit use template and we'll be led to this page. Here we are in our template, and Canva actually has two accounts. I have a paid account which leads me to this brand area, and this brand area means that I am able to load up all my logos and also load up a color palette, which makes things very easy. I can also load up custom fonts. See here, I've got this custom font which I have paid for and I use in my brand. But you can certainly use the free version of Canva. And if you don't want to pay for a version because you don't think you're going to use it, you could actually sign up for a 30-day trial and use the brand assets. And then when you're done, you can cancel your membership if it's not working for you. The other way to do it is to upload all of these images just as image files. So let's head back to our template, and we've split the template into three sections: the logo, the palette, and the fonts. The way that Squarespace actually orders the colors and the fonts is by creating these site styles. This is the site style for the colors, and you can see we've got a palette up here. I have actually drawn our brand guide to reflect that palette to make it simple and easy. And in this brand guide, this is saved as a group, so you may have to ungroup this, and you can then go into each color and then just pick the color that you would like that will match the brand that you want to set. We usually start off with the lightest colors on the left. This should be a white. And a trick, actually it's a white. And a trick is if it's a white and you want to show it, you can just put a very thin border. Let's just put a thin border here so you can see that it's actually a white inside, and this is going to be this gray, this is going to be this beige, this is going to be the orange, and this is going to be the black. And you can see here from the screenshot that we can customize each of these themes. On this section here, this reflects these themes that you have on the right. For example, the lightest is the white and the black. Where are we? The black here. And then we can go in and change all the colors to suit. This is our gray. And this is our orange. And then this is our dark brown and our orange. And so you can go down and do exactly the same thing for each. For example, at the bottom, we have got our black here and our beige as the writing, and you can just go in. And the good thing about this is once you print this, you can leave it beside you. And as you're deciding which section should be what color, you can keep it beside you for a reference so that you know which one you're choosing. Sometimes using these names, which is the Squarespace names, can be a bit confusing. Here we can actually go to our website, have it set up in coolers. I can just go in and copy that here, and let me just adjust that. And then we have a guide here that actually tells us what the color is. Let's say we want to have this color here, the pink. We can go back to our brand guide, change that to the pink, whatever color it's going to be. Actually, it was the pink. It wasn't the gray. It was the pink. here. We can just make sure that we have copied that in here and then change this out to the pink color. We have a very nice typed out sheet that we can make into our brand guide. Finally, with the fonts, you can see here again with the site styles, Squarespace actually sets out these global text styles. They have headings, paragraphs, and a miscellaneous. This might be a handwriting font or something that will be used for very sparingly throughout your website to attract attention and to break up the two main fonts. Here I've actually replaced my fonts. This is a screenshot from my site, but I've actually replaced these headings with a custom font. You can certainly do that, but ultimately you can control the base size, and then as you go into all these menus, you can then control the size of your fonts in certain situations, and that's certainly done. I hope this has explained how you can use Canva to create this brand guide, and I encourage you to when you're finished is to download it, and I would download it as a PDF print and print that off and have that next to you while you're designing. So I hope you found this brand guide video helpful. Don't forget, I have a whole series of videos on setting up an interior design database in Notion, so make sure you check that out. We're nearly finished. I think we have around 2 videos left, and then we'll have built out our entire Notion interior design dashboard. I'll leave a link in the description, and I hope to see you there. See you in the next video.